Yes, what you saw was the profit, and it is in US dollars. If you convert that figure into Indian rupees, it will be over 5 lakh rupees. I don't have much experience in the stock market, and still I can make this much profit. If you want to know how I made this much profit, watch the video till the end. Please leave a like and also share this video with others so that they can also learn something from this video. If you are new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. As you must have read from the title and also from the thumbnail, I have used machine learning technology to predict the future price of a stock and placed my bid on that. So the prerequisite for this video is that you should have a little knowledge of standard deviation concept, and you should be familiar with little bit of any math operations, if not more. Apart from this, if you know Python, that will put you at an advantage. But if you don't know any of this, don't worry, I will share the code with you. The link will be in the description box below once our like target reaches 100. So let's start with the core concept used in the code to understand the working better. We are going to use the LSTM model, which is also known as long short-term memory model. It is an artificial recurrent neural network. You can also refer to as RNN architecture, which is used in the field of deep learning. So for predicting the future price of a stock, first we need to train our model. So the approach will be something like this. We will first find out all the data points or the closing price of stock since 2010. It will give us an ample amount of data. We will be only taking the closing price as the base for predicting the price of the stock. Once we have enough data, we will feed 80% of the data to the LSTM model. This will train our model. One thing to note here is that training the model correctly is absolutely crucial. You will see what technique is used to calculate the error when I explain the code. So stay tuned. Now if you are thinking about what will happen to the rest 20% of the data, then we will use it to check our model it has been trained or not properly. We will ask our model to predict the future price of the data which comes under this 20% category, and later we can compare the actual value to our predicted value. This will give us a fair understanding of how well our model can predict the future price and how much error we have to consider. So now let's move on to the code and see this in action. In our code, we are taking Apple stock, and we will find out the future closing price of Apple on 22nd November 2021. We are running this model on 20th November 2021, and we have this Saturday-Sunday gap until the market opens on 22nd November. All the past data of Apple are taken from AlphaVantage website. AlphaVantage is a site that allows you to take all the necessary stock information free of cost. You just have to generate your free API key and use it in the code. We are going to take the information from 1st January 2010 till 31st October 2021. So that is approx 12 years of data. Now you can see we got our data from 4th January till 29th October because of the trading holidays in between. So 1st, 2nd, 3rd January was a trading holiday. Now if we plot the graph of this data, we will see similar peaks over the years. As we have discussed earlier, we will only use 80% of the data to train our model. Here we will use the mathclick function to take the 80% of the data set. We are using ceiling just to make sure we get a round figure. So the total data set was 2993, and its 80% will be around 2395 after the ceiling function is applied. Now another important aspect of machine learning is that you have to prepare the data before feeding it to any model. Preparing the data may include all these steps from data collection to data processing and then transforming the data. Since we have already collected the data from AlphaVantage website and processed only the closing price, now we just have to transform the data to be able to use it in our model. In this case, we will use min-max scalar to change our data points into scalar properties, which is between 0 and 1, including the values. Next, we need to decide the layers of our model and then build our model accordingly. Since this is just a pet project, we will keep the layers simple. We will have a total of 4 layers on our model, starting with 50 inputs whose return sequence is true, and second layer is 50 cells with the return sequence as false. These return sequence decide whether the output of the cells will be a sequence of the same length or not. Next will be the first dense layer, which will have 25 cells, and the last layer is the output dense layer, which will have only one cell. The next step is to optimize the model. We will use an ADAM optimizer. ADAM is a replacement optimization algorithm. This is for stochastic gradient, decent for training deep learning models. I will not bore you with the in-depth details of this optimizer, but just to tell you, it is the best among the adaptive optimizers. And now to calculate the error in our model, we will use the mean squared error concept. The mean squared error concept is that it takes the average squared difference between the estimated value and the actual value. So that will give us a fair idea of how much difference it will create. Since now we have everything we need, we can train our model. So we will pass our transformed data in one batch size with one epoch. One epoch is a term used in machine learning and indicates the number of passes of the entire training datasets the machine learning algorithm has completed. So you can increase this value by 1, 2, 3 or whatever you feel like. After completing the training, we can actually go ahead and test our model with the remaining 20% of the dataset. After testing, we get a graph something like this. Here, blue line indicates the data we used for training the model, red line is the actual close price of the stock in the testing data, and the orange line indicates the price predicted by our model, which is almost overlapping, which is a good sign, and also the root mean squared error is around 10 to 12, so that means our model is working very decently. Now the time has come to predict the future price of Apple. Now since our model is trained, we can provide less duration of data to get the prediction. In this case, we will provide the last 60 days data so that it can pick up the trend and also how the stock is performing recently. This gives us a value of 160, which can be taken as 162 or 63 as per given the mean squared error. So that's it guys, you can take a screenshot of this value and check this price on Monday and comment down if the price was as predicted or there is a lot of difference. I have tested the model on Apple stock and the price prediction was almost the same as we saw at the starting of the video. The value of the stock can be improved by reducing the root mean squared error value. So which is now at 10 or 12, if this value is very close to 0, then our model will work much better. If that happens, we can obviously train our model again and again to reach almost a perfect score, just like we saw in starting of our video. Please like and share this video. Let's reach the 100 like target and then I can share the code with you guys so that you can also play with the code and make a profit. Remember, investing in stock market can be risky, so make sure you take advice from your financial advisor before investing. I will see you in the next week, next video. Till then, stay safe and keep learning. Thank you.